Error, P0301 PX script of Dodge Ram 1500. 2014 Dodge Ram 1500 came in for service. The customer complaint is about misfire problems in cylinder number 1. Over the past 3 months, the truck has been to 5 different garages. The owner informed us that the following work has been done. The spark plugs were replaced. The ignition coil in cylinder number 1 was replaced. The injectors were swapped between cylinder number 1 and number 2. DTC P0301 is stored, cylinder number 1 misfire. We checked the compression in the cylinder. Compression reading is normal. When all the relevant tests were done, I asked Andrew Shulgin, the author of the PX script, to help in diagnosing the problem. For a quick troubleshooting, we need to compare the operation of the problem cylinder with a good one. To perform a comparison test, we use 2 identical PX35 pressure transducers with PXFlex flexible extensions. We will install the first transducer with an extension in the problem cylinder number 1. By the way, in this engine, 2 spark plugs work simultaneously in each cylinder, which are serviced by 1 ignition coil. We only need to remove one of the 2 spark plugs and install the pressure sensor. To synchronize the measurements, we connect the sync probe to the ignition coil of cylinder number 1. We also connect to the crankshaft position sensor. The ignition coil is connected to a spark gap tester using plug wires and boots. The second pressure transducer is installed in the good cylinder number 6. Now we can simultaneously receive and compare signals from 2 cylinders at the same time and compare them to each other. We start the engine. Then we slowly and smoothly raise the speed from 3000 to 4000 RPM. We release the throttle back to idle. Then we depress the throttle to wide open. When the engine reached 4000 RPM, we turned off the ignition while still holding the throttle wide open. During this test, we received pressure graphs from the problem cylinder and from a good cylinder. So, let's analyze. Channel number 1, pressure transducer in cylinder number 1. Channel number 2, pressure transducer in cylinder number 6. Channel number 3, crankshaft position sensor. Channel number 4, ignition sync pulse from cylinder number 1. You can see that the signals are different from each other. Let's move on to processing the pressure signal in cylinder number 1. Run the script. Select the channel number 1 and the sync signal. This is what the signal analysis results look like. We perform a similar test for cylinder number 6, the pressure graph of which is displayed in channel number 2. In the left corner is located the valve timing diagram. This is a standard valve timing diagram. In the right corner is shown a cross-section of the engine. Now we can see the operation of the gas distribution mechanism inside the engine. We begin the test and rotate the engine flywheel. We see how the camshaft cams rotate and how valves open and close, distance and time. We also see the moments of filling the cylinders with air-fuel mixture. This animation is the result of decoding the signal from the pressure transducer. The actual shape and dimensions of the camshaft cams displayed on the animation depend on the measured characteristics of the cylinder pressure graph. According to the valve timing diagram, the opening and closing angles of the valves are visible, as are the overlap zones. We examined the signal of the good cylinder. Now consider the signal of the problem cylinder. Let's compare these pictures. Let's take a look at the animation. I think that many have already understood what the problem is. It is clearly seen that the geometric dimensions of the intake camshaft cam are smaller than what is normal. Therefore, the intake valve opening time is not sufficient for the normal filling of the cylinder with a fresh air fuel mixture. This point is clearly visible in the animation. Let's pay attention to the valve timing diagram of these cylinders. As you can see, there is also a difference in the operation of the intake valve. We will verify our finding by visually inspecting the operation of the inlet and outlet valves again using a video borescope. Gently rotate the crankshaft, always in a clockwise direction, and observe the operation of the exhaust valve. The phase diagram in the red sector clearly shows the beginning of the opening and closing of the exhaust valve. Everything works great here. Here is the TDC. According to the phase diagram in the green sector, we see the operation of the intake valve. We are watching the opening of the valve. It can be seen that this is clearly not enough to fill the cylinder with the air-fuel mixture. The intake valve should open in the same way as the exhaust valve. This problem with the Dodge Ram 1500 is known in North America, and many mechanics are familiar with it. This is going to be an expensive and difficult repair. Replacing the camshaft. Replacement of hydraulic lifters. Maybe also replace rods and rocker arms. Plus consumables and gaskets. Here is the price of error P0301. Note that this problem is most common on engines equipped with cylinder deactivation, variable displacement.